Welcome back, Syndicate members. It is I, Joshua Mammoth, back from a long hiatus, ready to review another independent comic book. And with me is the beautiful mistress of the Mammothverse, Rachel. How are you doing?
I'm so glad to be back. How are you doing?
I'm doing wonderful. I got a few things here before we get started on tonight's selection. So first off, we got the C word, the name that is not to be mentioned.
Yeah, we got really sick in January, and it led into February, and then of course our 9-to-5 job suffered, so you know we had to get caught up there, so we're finally recovering.
Yeah, it was a rough go.
Really was. I can't believe it's already March.
Yeah, definitely. January is like it didn't even happen.
Oh yeah, that was like a New Year thing. I'm just kind of, it was like a pre-trial. Mm-hmm. We're just like, that didn't happen.
Yeah. the second bit of news, though, is I finished the pencils on the new book.
Yes.
Which is going to be named soon. I haven't got the cover done because I'm still going back and forth on a few different things I want to do, but the pencils for the book's done. What do you think?
Oh, and it looks amazing. I'm so lucky that I get like a super behind-the-scenes look. And I've got to see it from start to finish, and it's so cool. Like, I think we're even going to do, like, a little video to show, like, the process, I guess you should say.
I think you're overselling it.
Oh,
actually, no, I'm very happy with the outcome, too. I think part of it was all of the art that we've been able to look at.
Oh, I agree. And it's just such a good variety of stuff. I think it really is inspiring.
Yeah, because you'll see me in here when I'm getting ready for the review. Like, I zoom into the comic. I look at the backgrounds. Because, you know, artists like to hide things.
Oh, I agree. Well, I know you do.
And we find stuff in there all the time. It's awesome.
It's always like a fun game.
I got the pencils done. I'm on to the digital process, which that's easier and faster for me. Because the pencils, you know, I got to really be in the, you know, and you know, it's sort of like in Mario when you get the star, you want to try to bust out as many pages as you can before the star runs out.
Because you got to be in like the zone.
Right. Yeah. So I had that star and I was busting them out.
Oh, that's fine.
You know, but for the digital work, I don't really need the star as much.
Oh, I agree. Yeah. You know, you're just so natural with that one.
Yeah, because you know, I do that for professionally too, so that part is much easier. So, anyways, the agenda. So, we do have a little backlog right now.
Yes.
Which, that's a good thing.
Mm-hmm.
That means you guys are responding to us. But the next one, we got two coming up, which the first one, Nico Smith.
That's right.
Ninja Nico number 2. I love this book. And Nico's such a cool guy, too.
Oh, definitely. I really love him.
Yeah, and he was just an out-of-the-blue meet at a Comic-Con.
So random. And again, that's why I love going to these little comic book conventions, because we really get to find people like that.
I agree. And, you know, that's what I encourage a lot of people to do when they're at conventions, is look for the booth where there's just a person there with, his books or her books.
Yes.
You know,
sometimes the best ones.
Yeah, you'll find some really good stuff. The second one that I'm really excited about, too, Gut Ghost. The Gut Ghost. It's more like it's about as thick as an annual.
Yeah, it really is.
And so he collaborated a bunch of his older books together into one collection. And so, I love it. It's really good.
Yeah, I'm really excited to do that one.
Yeah, and we got that at Ancient City this year, where we got to interview his son.
So that was the best.
Yeah, so that was a great interview. And of course, you know, Enzo, he's the best. You know, I definitely support any all of these guys.
Oh yeah. That's what's so good about the indie circuit, I feel, in general, is just everyone is such a just so cool to talk to, so cool mm-hmm. to just hang out with.
And you know what? The artists have actually hit us up, too, under their respective videos.
Yeah.
You know, of course, Lewis did. You know, I love that guy. He's so awesome. And he's
Another great one, friendly
to deal with. Haley Martin hit us up. Roland Mann.
Super exciting when that happened.
Yeah, so I really love that. And then also, I want to put a special shout out to the syndicate members that made purchases based off of our reviews.
We love seeing that.
Yeah, that was for Tuskegee Airs, which I bought the graphic novel for that
one. Oh, because it was so good.
Yeah, and you know, we got to meet the creators for them too. We met them at, I want to say MegaCon a few years ago.
Gosh, it's been so long now, I forget. But I remember the book, definitely, for sure.
Well, MegaCon was so packed, it was hard to find a lot of stuff, but they had that big Tuskegee Airs banner at the top there.
That's right. I do remember that. That was very eye-catching. Mm-hmm. I think that's what made us go over there, because we're like, whoa,
I had heard of them, but I just I hadn't really seen anything. So I talked to the creator. That was, unfortunately, that was before we had a mobile camera.
Mobile.
But, I wasn't really doing the interviews at the cons, but we're going to do more of those too this year.
For sure.
So a shout out to those guys. I'm going to take a sip of your soda here. And then the second one was for Kayless.
Oh, right. Yeah. Another great one.
Yeah, so once you get those books in your hands, let me know what you think. Because
mm-hmm.
I'm really interested to find out if you like those as much as I did.
I agree.
Okay. Here we go. So, tonight's selection, this was a pickup from Daytona last year. Martin Piero with Cosmic Times, and it's entitled Deep Space Tragedy.
And I love the title already.
The title is awesome. The cover is amazing. I got my copy right here. Well, I'm stoned or not. I have my copy right here. Unfortunately, I've read this thing so many times, it's got a few spine wears on
it
there.
It does.
Because, wow, the art in this is so cool. It's different.
Yes.
And it really goes with the story so well.
Well, I remember when we first saw it, again, it was another great eye catcher that we were just like, whoa, this is different. First, robots are throughout. Indeed. So you're just like, oh, I think I got to check this out.
Martin gave us a great breakdown.
That's right.
And his energy was so good. So I love the Cosmic Times. Cosmic Times. And we actually have more to review from them, too. That new Arthur book. Oh, I can't wait for that.
Oh, that was, again, another one. I'm like, okay, gotta get that
mm-hmm.
one.
Yeah, so, and then the one that we reviewed for Halloween, From Blood.
That's right.
Yeah, that was another one. And so if you guys missed out, I'll put that link down there for
definitely
you so you
check
can check
it out.
So, Deep Space Tragedy. Now, what I found interesting about this book was that the story, art, lettering, and cover were all by the same guy.
Very impressive.
Yeah, Mike Wagner. So I was like, wow, this guy is really talented.
Yeah, I agree.
So basically, the book starts with one of our lead characters.
Yes.
And he's falling. And he's kind of not scared or anything. He's just kind of like, how would you describe it?
Well, it's kind of odd, too, because he's falling like in outer space, what it seems
yeah.
like. So I was already like, okay, this is different. But he doesn't seem, he just seems more confused, like, whoa, what's happening right now?
Right, okay, yeah, I would say confused as well. Mm-hmm. And he's falling down, and then we find out that he's actually dreaming.
Yes, and I thought that was crazy, and I was like, wow, robots dream, mm-hmm. like, who would have thought? But apparently,
See, I always thought that robots dreamt of digital sheep, but apparently they do other stuff, too. But when he wakes up, you see another robot, and he's I guess he's like plugged into something.
Yeah, I wasn't
too
sure.
Maybe a recharger or something.
That's what I was thinking. Yeah.
And so the guys, they're basically on the backstage, getting ready for a concert.
Yes.
And it looks like there's three robots here. Actually, Jarek. Now, Jarek's the one that was falling.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And then Dolus, he's the guy that has that, like, mighty, like...
Loved that. Right? Yes. I thought that was just, like...
Yeah, he's like, bam. I was like, okay, that's my dude right there. And then I think his name is Debbie.
Yeah, so I think that's how you say it. Yeah.
So these guys are all in the band together.
Which, mind you, he's the one with the massive hair,
yeah,
right?
The massive hair, yeah.
I love that too.
So they all kind of have their style.
I agree.
And you know what I really love too is the way that they talk in this book.
We're gonna get to that later.
Oh yeah. Well, in by the second page, you're like, yo, this is good.
This is good.
they're talking backstage and they're about to go on to a show, and then the story goes to a different area.
Yes.
Of what we come to find out is a place called Cog.
Yeah, that's what I took from it. Mm-hmm.
Now, this guy, he's a big fan of the band, which actually is the title, Deep Space Tragedy. Also, it's a really clever name for
a
band.
I'm like, what a crazy name for a band. Yeah. I loved it.
I mean, you think, like, Ripley would be in that, but... Anyways.
She was the original.
So this guy, his name is Rick Riggett. Uh-huh. He receives a weird box.
Yeah, which always be suspicious of that. But yeah, he's like, oh, just go ahead and take this in.
Yeah, he was like, you know what? This is really suspicious, but I'm going to open it and see what's in it. And he's kind of like fiddling with some type of receiver.
Yeah.
Because I guess he does bootleg copies of the music.
That's right. Okay.
Okay, so...
Or at least attempts to. I hope that was some issues at some point.
And he attempts to.
Yeah.
But once he opens this device in there, it automatically clears up the transmission.
Oh, right. So he can all of a sudden get everything mm-hmm. together. Mm-hmm.
Now, his friend, Dom.
Yes.
Dom arrives, and they're going to the actual tragedy concert.
Yeah, because they got like a little invitation saying, hey, free concert, you know, last minute. It's going to be here. Be there.
And that'd be like, you know, your favorite band is given a free concert, and you can go all the way up front.
Yeah.
Yeah, you got to go.
At least
right, yeah. You gotta go. But he tells Dom about this device that he got, and Dom's like, dude, you like opened something you didn't even know?
Like, he said, like, Dom, you're the guy.
Yeah, I mean, that box could have exploded.
Literally. Has he not watched me from the mines?
I know, like, you open a box, man, without knowing.
That's just no good.
No, well, we do watch too much Criminal Minds, and like, what's that Unabomber thing we said, too?
This is probably why I'm so skeptical of the box.
Yeah, so... In any case, so they head off to the concert.
Yes. And they're like, okay, this is going to be epic. We're gonna go do this.
Now, unbeknownst to Dom at the time, but he brought the device with him.
Yes. Which, again, I don't understand why... It's like, oh, I got this crazy box. Let me take it with me.
Well, he takes the he doesn't have it in the box anymore.
Oh, that's right.
But,
he just has it.
But still. We find out why he takes it in a little bit. Yeah, we do.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So, basically, at that point, Deep Space Tragedy is then, like, announced. Now, before they're announced, this glitchy bot is, like, leading them down the passageway, right?
He's freaking me out.
And he's saying, and he was like, yo, I got the beat. So if you guys need extra, yo, I'm the bot.
I'm the guy.
You.
Yeah, like this was his moment. He was about to go.
Yeah, and they go out there like, who the heck was this guy?
But I don't know if you noticed. Why did you have to point out that there were instruments, guitars, they were like glowing.
Yeah,
were,
I think like, they were so maybe cool. Like hologram instruments.
Yeah, I'm sure
light.
They were some kind of light bot.
They look cool
electronic.
As frack. Okay.
Double fry.
Yeah, those instruments were awesome. And I think I remember Martin telling us that they were light.
Yeah,
we'll have to double check that. And
yeah.
We'll put it like right down to the you know, he was right again. So actually on the way out, Dala says that, you know what, he's going to do his solo.
Oh, I know. He's like obsessed with doing the solo.
Doing the solo, and he's going to do it. And not the attention, Khan.
No, he's doing it.
I thought it was kind of awesome. I was like, you know what? I'm feeling it. I'm going to do my solo.
Everyone's like, you want your solo. Like, dude.
I want the solo. Okay, so this, once they're announced, this was like an amazing double splash page, right?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
This one, like, it really, like, took me back because I wanted to sit there and actually, like, absorb this one. And it was great.
Oh, it was amazing. And again, they just looked so cool. I just thought it just, you wanted to be at that concert.
But it's important to point out, though, you learn some information on these pages that's very important. So don't get caught up with the art. Because, at the top of the page, there's, like, some narration there. Mm-hmm. And it says that we played for hours to an audience who needed to connect as badly as we did. And the energy was off the charts. So, and I just thought that was really good writing. But then at the bottom, we find out that Deep Space Tragedy is actually wanted criminals.
I know, and I'm like, oh, the plot.
Fugitives running for their digital lives.
Digital lives.
Actually, it just says live through the digital. Now, while they're playing, though, Rigget, you know, tells Dom that he has the device.
Yeah. And he's like,
why would you bring that? But it was a super mistake, for one thing, because there's a guy, or I won't say a guy, there's a bot in the crowd that's actually looking for this device.
Yeah, and it seems like he's kind of watching him now, or he heard him, something, so he knows he has it, so he's just like stalking this poor little bot.
Well, you know, he's like that gangster that actually gets away with a lot of money and then goes and buys a really expensive car. Or actually, you know what? That was Richard Pryor in Superman 3.
Remember him?
The guy's like, I'll never find out who it is unless he's really dumb.
He literally like slides into this crazy looking sports car.
You know what? I love that movie. I only watch it for Richard Pryor anyway.
That's awesome. So funny. I love it.
Anyway, so he contacts the command.
Oh, right.
And what I thought was cool, too, is they're, I guess they have, like, wireless connections.
And it's scary. It's like the Borg.
It is kind of like that, but with zero organic.
Oh, that's true. Yeah, I didn't think
but
about that.
But they can, like, connect and talk to each other, and then it, like, kind of shows their face a little bit.
Oh, that's true. Yeah, I didn't think about that part.
We're not really sure how it works, but it obviously does work. And then
that's pretty cool.
He basically says, "Yo, you need to send me some backup."
Yeah, like I'm gonna need reinforcements.
Which sure. I mean, really, I mean, you see these two bots; they're clearly not.
Hey, if a bot can be deceiving. There we go.
That's true. I read a Star Wars comic book once where a protocol droid was killing people. It was like a programmed serial killer or something.
That's scary. It's like my worst nightmare.
Yeah, I don't remember what that was. Anyway, I'm like really trailing off here. So basically, yeah, that happens. And then Dom has the clutch idea to meet the band after the show's over.
Oh,
but he's
like,
well, you know what, we should. And he brought that device. And then we find out why Rigget brought the device. Mm-hmm. He wants to show the band.
Yeah, and he thinks he can like barter with it.
Yeah, because he wants to get off of Cobb.
Right.
And so we find out, okay, so there's other worlds in this universe. Mm-hmm. Not just this planet, but other planets.
And it's not looking good that they're in a very good part of the world.
No, and you know what, it also, there's were hints that were dropped within the story that apparently on this lower level,
right,
this is where all the rusted out old bots go, or bad code as they call them.
Yeah.
Which I thought that was pretty clever too.
I do think that was clever.
It dropped hints that, you know, there's something in control of this world.
Right.
Right. Mm-hmm. Without hesitation, they go into the alleyway where they think the band's going to be coming out of. Because I guess the door is in the back and the band's going to come out of there to leave.
So they're going
to
fangirl
like,
it out.
And like incognito, because you know they're fugitives, so they got to get out of there. So he actually pulls the device out in the alleyway, though. Because they think they're... It is really a dumb idea. I mean, this bot is clearly not thinking with a full battery.
Well, I honestly think the bot... He's like a little kid, though. At least he appears to be. He's so cute, though. He's like little.
He has childlike programming.
There you go.
Yeah. Dom is clearly thinking, sir. He's like, what the hell are you doing?
He's like the preteen teenager. Mm-hmm.
And so it actually... The device activates.
Yes. It starts glowing, and it's like, oh, we're standing out now.
Yeah, and so I actually really love the way they pulled this off, though. This art here looked really good.
Oh, it looked amazing.
And then, so the, I guess they were bot goons or something. They rush them. They come in, they rush them. And then one of them grabs the device and it, like, transmits or something.
I don't know what it does, but yeah.
Yeah, it transmits a signal just up and then... over the city, and it kind of spreads out.
I think it, like, evaporated that guy or something. That's kind of what I assume.
Well, I think they were called Shockers. I don't remember.
Oh, right.
But in any case, yeah, he's obliterated. And so what this does, though, is it actually activates something inside Jarrett.
Yes, that part. I was like, oh, here we go.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and so he begins to kind of act a little strange, and then so the bots in there are, I don't say strange, I want to say glitchy.
Glitchy.
Yeah, because I think that's what they called it in the book. And he's saying, you know, the hour is calling and everything, and then they're like, yo, are you okay?
Yeah, he's like, oh, my head, right?
Mm-hmm. And then we find out that these were visions that he was having. You know,
yes.
They're not dreams, they're visions of something that's going to happen. And they're not going to be leaving Cog right now.
No, he's like, nope, it's about to go down. We need to stay. This is, I was freaking out. I was like, oh, you're having like a vision? You're not. It was weird enough he was having a dream. And I'm like, wow, now you're having a vision? Like, oh mm-hmm. my gosh.
And so, which was really cool, is he opens the door to go outside where the, you know, all the business is happening. Mm-hmm. That's where the comic ends.
Literally, to be continued. I'm like,
and, you know, this is one that we didn't pick up the other issues on. Because we picked up a bunch of Cosmic Times.
Right.
Because I wanted to read a bunch of titles.
Well, I just want variety.
But now I'm thinking, man, I really should have picked up. I should have just picked two.
Yeah.
And then just bought all the issues.
Well, we've learned a little bit from them. Yeah.
You know, because, like, you know, with Kayless, I picked up all of those issues. I'm glad I did.
Yeah.
Because I was like, man, that's a cliffhanger. There. But this one was a really good cliffhanger, and I love the sci-fi aspect of it.
I love the robots, how they looked, what it was, even just the art and everything. It was really cool.
You ready to break this biscuit down?
Oh, definitely.
All right, Syndicate members, it's time for our detailed analysis. So sit back and listen to my soothing voice.
Oh my God.
So I'll start here with the lights. There are a lot of really clever quotes in this book.
That's actually something that I really liked about it. I had to actually write down a couple. I loved just the way that they used the fact that they were robots into how they spoke. Like, one time they're like, this is bad code. I have a feeling we're in over our processors with this
one. Oh, wow. I wrote that one down, too.
I thought that was so funny. But then another, it's like, oh, my code. Like, oh.
And, like, the whole calling on the airwaves thing.
Yes.
Yeah, that kind of gave me, like, a pump up the volume vibe.
Oh, well, one of the rockers, like, I'm programmed to rock.
Right,
like,
I'm programmed.
Stop. I'm like, I love that. Yeah. Like, dude, me too.
The writing was so good on this book.
It was so cute.
I had to read it a couple of times because it was just so funny.
And again, I just loved all the little, like, nuances. Like, you wouldn't even think about it. But I'm like, yeah, if you're a bot, you would speak mm-hmm. differently. Like, and I was just, like, really appreciative of how much detail they put into it.
What did you like?
Actually, the dynamic between the band members, I thought it was so funny. Again, great writing, because I literally thought they had been together for years. They were playing off each other. He's like, oh, I love you. Does that mean you love me? Like, they were just being so cute. Like, you could imagine, like, a bunch of guys would just act like that to each other.
And they also had very distinctive looks for being robots.
Oh, actually, that was something else that I liked, is something, how they looked. The guy with the chin or the crazy beard, however you want to say it, and then the hair. And then even the main character, he was, like, blue. He looked so cool.
And didn't he put a hat on at some point? Put a hat on when he started to rock, I think.
I think you're right, yeah. But I just thought it was so cool. He was, like, blue. They were, like silverish or whatever. But, yeah, I think it just looked awesome.
And, yeah, it was really good, that play. Like, the writing was just so cool.
So cool, yeah.
And he really took the time to put those details in there.
Oh, I agree. That's actually something I really liked about it, was just the fact of all the details. If you really looked at the background, the buildings, it was colorful, but it was dark in the same sense. Like, it was just really awesome how it was done.
I really liked the hologram instruments.
Oh gosh, yes. Just something I love. I just thought that looked so cool. Like, they were like this light, and you're just like,
you can just think of like a robot playing that.
Right? Yeah. It looked really awesome.
What did you think of the intro? When Jarek was falling.
Oh man, well first, you know, fear of myself. Like, that's crazy. I would hate to have those dreams. Since you wake up and you're like, oh gosh, you know. And the fact that, you know, the other bots were concerned about, like, oh, we're not supposed to dream. Why are you dreaming? Like, okay, we'll figure this out after the show. We gotta rock hard, you know. But the fact that it wasn't even a dream, it was, like, a premonition, is even creepier somehow.
Yeah, I really liked that intro. It pulled me in right away.
Right, it was, like, got right to the point.
And then there's a splash page where it shows the main title. Deep Space Tragedy. What do you think that is? Because to me, it looks like the device.
Oh, well, I for sure think that's what it is, because it almost looks like the an invitation or something on it.
Yeah, it was really cool. I was really looking at it. I was trying to pick it apart to see, because the device, when it activates, it's really tiny on the page, so you can't really make it out too well, but this thing is cool.
So, again, so much detail, all of the different, you know, lines that are on it, and again, it's like not gritty, but it's just got such a different look to it that I'm used to with other comics. I just think it's so cool looking.
Yeah, and you know, I always say that comics can have a very wide range of art. Like, it doesn't really have to look any specific way, and so I enjoy looking at the different aspects, and this one was different, and I think I'm gonna have to get the rest of these.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah, so...
Right after this.
What did you love?
Ah, the little bot.
Riggit,
he was so cute! I swear, he's shorter than me, which is saying something.
Yeah, he was a tiny dude, and I kind of liked his piracy aspect.
Oh, no, he's like, I'm getting out of here. Let me show you how he's done. And then the other guy's like, oh, God, which I actually loved his friend, too, because I'm like, he's just going along for the ride. He's obviously so much smarter than his friend.
Definitely. I love the big tooth splash pit, the big spread right there when they actually came out on stage.
Oh, that was so cool. Again, I was like, be there. I don't even think that's possible, but I want to be there. They are going to rock so hard.
You get a really good, clear view of their instruments on that page, too.
Yes, and honestly, just them, and they just, they again, which is so awesome.
And, you know, Dom and Riggit are right up front.
Oh, they were not playing. They were like, if I gotta elbow my way in here, I'm gonna do that. Well, it could be elbow. It's like joint their way in.
Now, I put that I actually loved the next issue page where it looked like they were kind of flying out or something.
Yeah. I was like, uh-oh. I was like, and you gotta grab it now.
And you can really, like, there's a lot of detail in the bots on that one, so you can really kind of see them and their different aspects. Because this one back here I thought was really cool too, but it's a silhouette more than anything.
Right.
Whereas, you know, this one has them like flying
at you.
So I'm really hoping to figure out what happens soon.
Oh, I know. Because actually that's something else I love too, is just all the splash pages, the backgrounds, just so cool to look at. It was fun to read, but just amazing to look at.
And also a different read.
Oh, yeah, because I just love the language that they use with the robots and stuff. I thought that was so clever.
Yeah, I definitely wrote the language down. That was really good. And then how also the story really came together. And you found out little tidbits here and there along the way till the end. And that's something I really do like, is just finding out the clues and trying to figure it out.
And I kind of do like the cliffhanger just because I'm like, okay, now I have to go and watch it.
I enjoy a good cliffhanger. Yeah. Actually, Cowboy Diplomacy ended on a cliffhanger. But I have plans for that. Sometime this century it'll be done.
You're funny.
Do you have anything else?
No, just I can't wait to read the next one. It was so much fun. I love the band characters, especially already. They are just so much fun to look at and to see. And man, I want to listen to their music now.
Well, I'll have all the Cosmic Times information down below, so make sure you hit them up, pick up some issues, let them know Joshua Manny sent you. Because they have a lot of titles.
Oh, definitely. And again, another wide variety, because we have another one. It's Arthur. That's like a medieval times. Medieval kind of scenario, and this is robot. So it's definitely a whole different spectrum for everyone.
Definitely. And, you know, Martin's awesome. So let him know that I sent you his way. And so we're going to go ahead and close this one out.
Yeah, I got to get online and order that next
one. All right, Seneca members, between the known and the unknown lies the man. I'll see you next time.